Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Praise Uche. I am a mommy vlogger based in Italy. I do content around family, lifestyle, entertainment, food, and every other good stuff. You know, if you like this face already, if you feel these vibes already, then you want to be a member of this beautiful family by hitting on that red subscribe button and also turning on the bell button so that whenever I upload any video, you shall be the first to know. And to my OGs, my special people, you guys already know now that you have a place in heaven and you are the world. Let me hear the comment section. Yeah. Okay, guys, today I'll be sharing with you guys what I miss about being single. What I miss about being single. I've been married for 4 years, guys. And sometimes I just be like, can I just be single for a while? Can I just go back to be single for a while? You know, just a short while and come back to be married. Before we dive into the video proper, let me just put it out here. All the single ladies, don't live your single life thinking, waiting, you know, planning, unhappy, worried about when you get married. Enjoy the moment. Enjoy your single life, because once you get married, oh, Barry, she can now. You saw those, baby, I love you, baby, this, all of them, bro. Small. It will just fade away. Okay, guys, let's go on this short break. I will be right back. Welcome back, guys. Okay, first thing I miss is freedom. Freedom, like the freedom to just be you, to do whatever you want to do at any time you freaking want to do it. You know what I mean? You know, to freedom to go. Now, if I want to go out, if I think of my children, how will I even carry them? Where will I even put them? I can't even just go out alone and just hang out alone, feel single in peace. Mba, see. A single girl, you have freedom to do whatever you want to do. You go to wherever you want to go at any freaking time you want to go. You know, but now, when you think of your husband, your children, and everything, just like, can I be single for today? And just for today? As a single girl, I can decide to cook. I can decide not to cook. I can decide to eat. You know, I can decide not to eat. But now, cooking is not a choice. It's a must. Like, morning, afternoon, night. Morning, afternoon, every day of your life, you are cooking because of your children. Yeah. Another thing I miss about being single is I feel accountable not just for myself, but for my kids, for my husband. I'm just worried about my kids. Like, oh, are they fine? If Nicole is in school, I'm like, has Nicole eaten? Is she fine? Is she playing well in school? Is she, you know, you are just worried about everything. You are just worried that when my dad goes to work, I'm always praying, God, take him out safely. Let him come back safely. You know, God, protect my husband. Protect my husband. Like, you are just worried about everything around you. Worried, thinking, showing too much care, too much concern. But a single girl, even boyfriend says, you don't send them. Another thing is buying or gifts. As a single girl, if I married my husband, any opportunity, any occasion at all, be it Valentine's Day, be it, you know, Easter Day, Christmas Day, whatever day it is, I know that I'm getting a gift. It's a deal. I'm getting a gift. Okay, my first year in marriage, I was still in Nigeria, so I got gifts on Valentine's Day, I got gifts on Christmas Day, I even got gifts on Easter Day. That was first year in marriage, you know, because it was still like a distance marriage, so I still feel more like a single girl. Second year, the same time, I was still in Nigeria. Third year, that was last year, when I came newly, I was still feeling, you know, I was just like a new bride, you know, I still had my gifts and everything. Guys, fourth year, hey, guys, let me give you guys a quick story. Last November, I actually asked my husband to get me a laptop, and I want a laptop. Now, my husband is the kind of person that doesn't say what he cannot do. If my husband says something, he tries so much, he will do everything possible to fulfill it. If I want something for my husband, I just need him to tell me yes. I just need him together. I just need him to say that yes. If he says the yes, it's a done deal. And he gives you a day. he will do it. He doesn't just promise because he wants to promise you at that moment so you can just allow him be, or just, you know, just to make you feel happy. Mm-mm. If he doesn't have, he'll tell you he doesn't have. If you want it, he'll tell you no. If you do it, he'll tell you yes. And if he says yes, it is a yes, you will definitely get it. So he said he's going to get it for me in December. December ending, because I asked him mid-November. So he said by next month ending, I'll get the laptop. I just took it for a yes. Like, I knew my husband would do it that month. But Oga shocked me, oh. December was coming to an end. I was not seeing any sign of anybody mentioning any laptop anyway. I didn't say anything. I don't want to invite him because he knows. I know him that will do it. December 29, December 30, December 31st. I did not see anything. I did not see laptop. And I'm like, mine, Alpha, you promised to get me a laptop this ending. Another ending, the ending don't reach now. Where my laptop? I was like, my, no, this month I really spent a lot. Next month ending, next month ending. I'm like, my, next month again. He said, yes, next month ending. I said, okay. I took it for it because he has not promised me and failed before. That was the first time. So I just knew for him to fail that it was unavoidable. Because he has never failed me before. He has never promised me something and give me a date and he doesn't do it. So I let that slide. Then I was January ending. In fact, then the pay salary, I was with him. He was asking me, will you eat pizza? I was expecting us to drive to SME where we'll buy laptop. My husband was driving home. I'm like, guy, how far? My laptop. He said, month never end now. When month end? I said, ah, okay now, when month end? Guys, month ended though. I did not see any shishi, I did not see laptop. I'm like, mine, how far? And my laptop. He said, mine, I promise you next month, February. If not possible, I'll give you February. You know, a lot of things came up, February. I said, mine, let's not pass February. You know, you've pushed this laptop for too long and I really need it. He said, February. Guys, I laughed, I didn't say anything. On Valentine's Day, my husband was the first person to wake me up in the morning. And he was like, happy vow, my love. I'm like, thank you, happy vow to you too. And he's like, don't worry, your gift is coming, okay? Don't ask me for Valentine's gift to your gift. I already have it in mind to buy you a gift for vow. I'm like, this is my husband by himself was telling me I should not worry about Valentine's gift, that he has the mind to buy me Valentine's gift. I said, okay, no problem. I'm not going to ask you since you've said it to yourself. I waited for my Valentine's gift. Valentine's Day passed. I did not see shishi. Oh, Jesus. Then our anniversary is 18th of February. That's our anniversary. Then 4 days after, that was 18th of February, our anniversary day. My husband woke me up in the morning again and said, happy anniversary, my love. Don't worry, your anniversary gift is coming. Oh God, the moment we humble you. He said, I should not worry you that my anniversary gift is coming. Only for, I think, 3 to 4 days after our anniversary. One night like that, I was not even expecting anything. My husband came back home and he bought a brand new laptop. Guys, you know what he said? He said, mine, this laptop is your Christmas gift, anniversary gift, and Valentine's gift. Oh, God of heaven. Guys, evil men, I said they will humble you. My husband actually postponed the laptop by asking to buy me since November. He definitely postponed it, and used one stone to kill three birds. He gave me the laptop that I asked him by myself to buy me laptop. Since November, we used that same laptop to do me Christmas gift, anniversary gift, and Valentine's gift. So, guys, this is what I miss about being single, because if I was single, I'll get my laptop, I'll get Christmas gift, I'll get anniversary gift, I'll get Valentine's gift, like, you will gift back to back. But for now, I'm even happy and grateful that I even saw the laptop. Otherwise, it will have been all year. It's my case. So I also miss getting a lot of gifts being single. You know? Then another thing I miss being single is no more frequent calls. Not like I miss, but sometimes. Because sometimes, throughout the day, my phone will not ring. Nobody will call me. The only time my phone will ring sometimes is alarm to go and pick Nicole from school. Guys, if you are single, you get married though. Marriage is sweet, it's honorable, but enjoy your single moment. Don't cut me wrong, I'm enjoying my married life. Like, I am enjoying my married life so well. But I just miss your single days, those days of freedom, those days of petting, you know, buying of gifts, No, just you, just be you and being accountable for yourself and yourself alone. You know, those days I miss them a lot. So let's continue this conversation in the comment section. Let me know what you miss as a single girl if you're married. And I will see you all in another video. Ciao, ciao.